Arbour, Al Arbour's wife, joined us during the second intermission, and she just told me a wonderful story off camera. She was actually the Islanders' first ever video coach. So back in the early 70s, in the humble beginnings of this franchise, Al Arbour bought the equipment, had her tape the games at home, and then he would review them with the players. She said the players started getting picky after a while. They said, Claire, could you please snip out the commercials? We don't want to sit through the commercials anymore. She even went on to say one time they were in a game and there was a questionable call, and the coaches called her and said, Claire, was that really a penalty? We just want to know. She said, you guys, I looked at the film, and yes, it was a penalty. Amazing stories from Claire Arbour. I'll send it back up to you guys. But boy, technology's come a long, long way.
Yeah, they didn't have any of those things back when Al Arbour first started. And Claire had the same love for the game as Al did, so no surprise that she was willing to pitch in.
Barzell threw one towards the net. It hit up off the chest of Vanders Lee and knocked down to the side. Now, during that last commercial break, right after Matt Martin took a shot, as Barzell steals it, Everly to the net, Barzell dropped it, nobody there.
It looked like Stamkos called for it, because Matt just dropped it blind and came right back and lifted the stick of Steven Stamkos. So good recovery from Matt Barzell.
Well, Casey Zizekas, I was about to tell you, had left the ice and had gone down halfway down the tunnel and was actually seated down, and they were working on him, and he just popped right back up, and now he's standing at the boards looking like he wants to get right back on the ice.
Maybe just had a little bit of a crap, Brendan, and needed to just massage it a little bit. Claire Arbour still watches the Islander game. She's a big fan of the New York Islanders, so she's told me on a number of occasions that she listens to you and I and enjoys us, but still is a very big fan of the New York Islanders.
She's got pretty good seats tonight.
Yeah, she does. She knows somebody, I'm sure.
Brock Nelson along the boards. Out for Thompson. Thompson to Pellick. Pellick throws it towards the goal. Everybody was tied up as it went by. Broussard feeds it back around. Thompson looks it over. Shoots it intentionally wide to make sure it doesn't get blocked. Broussard for Beauvillier. Nelson's in the slot. Beauvillier trying to shake free. Comes around for Broussard. Right back down into the corner. Angles to the front. One hand. Nelson rebound. Scores! The Islanders get a bounce. Brock Nelson stayed with it. His second try goes in, and the lead is back to two.
Just a great job of forechecking. Talk about playing in the offensive zone. That line with Nelson, Broussard, and Beauvillier. So Coach Trotz puts these guys back together, and they come up with something. Just good work in behind the net. They have a feel for one another. We've seen this chemistry before. Beauvillier back and forth, back and forth. Look at the support down low, and then Brock Nelson gets a fortuitous bounce, stays right with it. As McElhaney wasn't able to handle that original shot, but boy, talk about good hard work by that threesome and that magic that they've had, and that'll make Coach Trotz just a little more difficult to keep them apart when they seem to be able to find ways to score goals. And you know, it's funny, I was just thinking, boy, Brock needs to score a goal. I mean, honestly, I was just thinking, boy, would he need a goal right now and help his team, and lo and behold, he must have been reading my mind.
Well, it's just his second in the last nine games, and it gives the Islanders a 3-1 lead. Ryan Pollock's shot was too wide.